Government should leave politics for now. Government should not drag themselves back and see
politics, they cannot leave politics now. 2023 election.
How they should sit back.
Nigeria is on a timetable, so they cannot leave the election.
Get off the timetable where people are dying. 5,000 people gone. 90,000 people displaced.
Welcome to this special episode on Noble TV. Today we'll be looking at flood and the challenges across various parts of the country. If you are in Nigeria, you're going to bear with me. You're going to bear witness to the fact that most states of the country is being overrun by flood. I believe you must have seen what's going on in the social media, various clips, that of Bayelsa, that of Kogi, even the roads. The roads are not left out. Our farms are not left out. It's a major challenge. So today we'll be looking at the flood, the causes, and what we need to do to save ourselves and help our fellow Nigerians. With me on set to discuss flood and the challenges in Nigeria is my very good friend, Mr. Chidi Peters. Mr. Chidi, you're welcome.
Thank you very much, Noble.
It's lovely having you today on set.
Thank you very much.
I will just go straight to what we are discussing about, flood and the challenges of flood in Nigeria. I believe you must have seen what is happening. Maybe you must have visited some areas and see what is happening. Do you have, is there a reason for this level of flooding across various parts of the country today?
Yeah, Nabo, thank you very much for having me this wonderful afternoon. The issue about flooding is, if you watch out in the United Nations, if you watch out in the EU's and so on and so forth, all that our international leaders, when I mean international leaders, leaders across the globe, keep talking about was all about climate change. Climate change in the east, in the south, in the west, and in the north is not peculiar to Nigeria. So the issue of flooding is not peculiar to Nigeria. Though Nigerian governments could have some percentage of blames for not taking precautionary measures. If you watch Northern Cameroon, that built a dam in Northern Cameroon in 1977 to 1982, Lado Jam, the dam was built in such a way that when they discharged the water will now flow into another dam, which was supposed to be very bigger. So that means Nigeria had an agreement with Cameroon to build another dam in Adamawa, where at the point of discharging of the water in Lado Dam, the water will cascade into a bigger one like a shock absorber. But in 1982, Nigeria abandoned their own. They failed to build it. And if Nigeria had built that dam in Adamawa, that dam was supposed to have an irrigation to irrigate up to 150,000 hectares of land for that area. That means we have farming all seasons. And of course, that dam was supposed to generate at least 300 megawatts of electricity in that area. But all these things were abandoned by Nigerian governments. I wouldn't know why, maybe because of paucity of fund, or maybe you could blame it as a sort of negligence on the part of governments. Now, because of that, each time that dam is open to discharge the impounded water, it tend to flood into Nigeria to affect some cities like Adamawa, Taraba, and so on and so forth. But this year's own is worse hit, just like a replica of what happened in 2012, where we have the same scenario. But it appears this time around is worse hit because we have, according to NEMA and the Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs, Nigeria have lost up to 500 lives. And of course, 90,000 homes have somehow been displaced. And of course, farmlands were damaged. That means in the next few months, Nigeria is going to enter into a food shortage. That is also another thing that bothers the country so much. So you can find out roads are cutting off. For example, now, if you can't travel from here now to Port Harcourt, you can't travel some part of the country because the bridges have collapsed, the roads are cut off because of heavy flooding. And again, government could be blamed because some of our roads, we don't have the waters are not properly channeled, you know, to channel the water to some areas where they're supposed to discharge or if for a destination. So that means when it rains, the flood had to find its route anywhere. That is also why we're having a lot of flooding. But flooding this year is because we have what I will call torrential rainfalls, you know, towards the second quarter, that is Q2 of the year. So that also, the rain was so much, even to today, it's been raining almost every day. So the NEMA have said that we should expect more flood, that the flood will not recede for now because they are going to open the dams and the rain is at its peak. But again, let me take you to those who want to blame government. We can't blame government in total because even in the United States of America, they're having the same. They call themselves Julia flooding, which have affected Central America, you know, causing a lot of, it's not a flash flood anymore. It's a heavy flooding. Of course, we have landslide here and there in African continent and African countries where even the Lado jam in the dam in Cameroon does not affect. So you can see it's a natural disaster. But at the same time, governments of Nigeria also have to begin to have what I will call proactive measures to ensure that all roads constructed have good drainage system, to ensure that some of the states also have water storms, you know, to challenge them properly. That will also assist for future reoccurrence. That also brings me down to IDPCs, where government, we are not proactive because by now, NEMA and NIMET has continued to predict rainfalls and opening of dam and flooding since February 2022. Yet government in all level, from the local government to the federal, none of them have set off IDP until now that they are going to begin to make a kind of makeshift IDP for people who are displaced. That is totally wrong. The federal government should make it a compulsory that every state in Nigeria should have an IDP well equipped with water, well equipped with school, well equipped with all the facilities, so that those who are displaced, neither by virtue of natural occurrence like flooding or natural disaster or banditry or whatever we have, some people in that community can easily be located at IDP where they're going to stay until the period of whatever event must have happened. But in Nigeria, we don't have such. And of course, that also brings to a consign where now government are appealing to spiritual individual to see how they can send palliative to these people. That shouldn't be the case. They are responsible. They are responsibility of the government, and government should be responsive to whatever the thing is.
Thank you so much. I've listened to what you just said, trying to explain what happened. But let me go back. You know, you said you don't want to blame the government.
In total.
In your words. And you took us to, you drew allusion to what is happening in the United States, some part of the world having challenge of flood.
Of course, you just have it. India have landslide, and Kenya have landslide, and so on and so forth.
Correct. And you talked about, you said torrential rainfall has been on the increase. But if I should ask, let's be specific about this now. If I should ask, do you think the level of rainfall would have necessitated this flood if the government, like you talked about the Nigerian government, if they had built the dam they had an agreement to do with Cameroon?
You know, I like being very, very objective. I don't know whether you have been to Kaiji Dam. If you discharge the whole water in Kaiji Dam, it will never flood the whole of Asaba. That is about the matter. Go and discharge the whole water there. What we are saying is there is a torrential rainfall everywhere. In Kenya, where they have landslides. In India, where they have the same thing. In Madagascar, where they have the same thing. Is it as a result of opening of dam?
Okay, no. Let's get this straight. You see, my question is simple. So what you say in essence is that even if we had built the dam, the agreement with Cameroon,
yes,
if we had built the dam, there would still be flooding. Is that what you are saying?
If I built the dam to serve as a shock observer of the discharge of the water from the Cameroon, at least let's assume 20-30% of the water would have been contained or would have been pounded in that dam. But the dam does not stop flooding, because successive government have not paid total attention from the local government to state government to drainage systems, to water, making waterways. Have you been to Nigeria recent time? The Wangene River, that was dredged by Peter Obi when he was governor. It was dredged by Peter Obi up to the River Niger. We also have a water collection storm that was built from Okonicha under the bridge, too close to Obogu, that is now filled up to the River Niger. We also have the same thing at Awada, collection of water from Awada, close to the storm at Iweka Road, close under storm, close to the bridge, the Oko Junction, and burst out to the bridge. We also have another one that came from inland town, a big water storm or drainage system built by Governor Peter Obi to ensure that Onitsha is not flooded. That one passed through Ochanja. Go back to that same place today. A lot of buildings have come up in those drainage systems. In Onitsha, for existence now, when Peter Obi was governor of Anambra State, I'm not trying to sing praises for him. I'm not trying to blame his trumpet. But when he was governor of Anambra State, he built a drainage system from Okpoko Onitsha stretch to Obogu. That was a very big drainage system that moved down straight to inside the River Niger. Then he collected the whole water from inland town, I remember phase two, from inland town straight to Iweka Road up to Ochanja Market, a drainage system that moved straight to River Niger. Then there's collection of water from Oguta Road up to 33 on it, and so on and so forth. The water storm that moved into Wangene River up to Fege, collection of water to that place. But you go there now, it has been blocked. That is why you have flooding on it. Because if those water were collected and they moved toward the same channel, I don't think it will be flooded. Even if it's going to be flooded, it's going to be a minimal damage, not a colossal damage as we've had it so far in Anambra State. So what I'm saying is that government should pay attention in creating and building roads with a very good drainage system that terminated into not just into a cockpit or whatever, into a river or a channel. We have had roads. Why did the East West Road collapse? We have had roads where government will create a drainage system and terminate it abruptly into nowhere. And when it rains, it begins to create erosion here and there. But when we channel this thing and move it to a canal or move it to a river or move it to anywhere, I think it will, the escalation of water will not be causing flooding. You move to anywhere in Nigeria, you find where government have built roads without proper collection of water into a drainage system. So such thing can also cause flooding.
It's okay. Thank you for that clarification. I will need to ask again. You talked about the building of roads and building of a drainage system. You talked about the drainage systems that we are building on each other. They are now blocked, and that's why there is no thorough way for water to pass through. But if I should ask, taking into cognizance this flooding now, do you think if the government, if they had dredged the River Niger, do you think we'll have this flooding challenge today?
Well, River Niger is an addition. If they had dredged the River Niger, it's an added advantage. But even when you dredge the River Niger, without proper drainage and refuse disposal, we are bound to be flooded. We are bound to have flooding everywhere. Thank God to Nigeria, we don't have landslides. Unlike what you have in Madagascar, what you have in India, what you have in Zambia, and other African countries. Even the United States that have even the most sophisticated whatever system they have, because they live by the Red Sea, by the Atlantic Ocean, they are still flooded. You go to Lagos, what I'm talking about. Lagos, because instead of us to bring the money we used to go and bring Eco Atlantic inside the water to use and develop other cities, we choose to go and fill a river and ocean and move on its own. So we should await the consequences of blocking Atlantic Ocean in the nearest future.
Well, it's okay. I wouldn't want to go into that, but I think the government must have done
it. It's my opinion.
I know. They must have done their feasibility study before doing
it. I'm a commoner. I don't do that. The feasibility is not working. If it's not working, we'll not be flooded.
But I think in their own wisdom, they think...
Have you been to Eco Atlantic?
Eco Atlantic is a good investment.
It's a good investment. What we are saying is that money expended there in blocking that river. If you have brought it to Ole, is it Ore? Is that what?
Ore.
Ore.
Yes.
Odo and developed, it would be more better for all of us. We have not reached advance of sand-filling water. We sand-fill water. America sand-fill water because they don't have more land to develop. But we have more land to develop. Come to anywhere. Go to Sokoto. We have empty land there. You drive from Zaria to Katsina.
You drive more than 200 kilometers away. The whole house is there. Go and develop it. The people will come. So I'm sampling the land.
It's okay.
Allow water to have its way.
It's okay.
It's natural.
I think what Lagos did, they are taking advantage of, like you take the little space they have. That's what Lagos.
They mustn't concentrate in developing Lagos. There are other places that need development too.
It's okay.
They own those states need development too.
It's okay.
If I brought the development to Benin City, that's another advantage. Whatever you develop, people will go there.
It's okay. Thank you very much. You talked about why you were responding to one of the questions. You talked about Nigerian government, they are not being proactive, they are being reactive.
Yes.
You understand? You talked about the IDP, you talked about NIMET, NEMA. They sent those notices as far back as February that there's going to be flooding.
Without a follow-up action.
And nothing was done by the government.
Not government. They are NEMA. The Humanitarian Affairs Commission. That are be feeding our school children when they're at home with billions of naira that were not even seen. They should use that same money and build IDP. NEMA have given warning since February. It's enough to construct IDP. IDP is not only meant for people who are displaced by Boko Haram or bandits. IDP also meant for people who are displaced by natural disaster, like we're having now in Ogbaru, Ogbipele, or Somala. And we're having in East West Road. We're having in Delta States. We're having in Taraba. We're having in Adamawa. We're having in Sokoto and so on and so forth. We're having in Niger. Niger, you can't go to Kotangurana. I hope you know that. The road has been cut off.
Yeah, I saw the one of Kogi State.
You can't even go to Kogi. Lokoja, who is epicenter of activities. You can't even go there again. Forcing federal government to make an announcement. Those who are displaced, what is their fate?
What is their fate? Well, you talked about the government being reactive. I think I heard, was it last 2 weeks, that Governor Wike River State provided 1 billion for those displaced.
In his own state.
Why Bayelsa government gave about 400 million for those displaced?
Is it enough? How much is a set of television? No, tell me now.
Okay.
The least television you get now, plasma TV you get now, 12 inches, it's about 70,000. What are the facilities inside the house? Is it the 400 million that is going to solve how many houses that are being condemned? The NEMA is talking about 900,000 houses. 900,000 people being displaced. But those who died, 500,000 who died.
We should be appreciative. At least that they did.
Are not appreciative. I'm talking on behalf of Nigerians now. We should have been more appreciative if they have built IDP camp. For people to go and, as the thing is that the announcement goes on, they shall move the ground, stay, and pack their things.
What we see.
Imagine
now,
where you live in Sokoto as a presenter. You are living in Sokoto, and you don't have anybody there in Sokoto, and they're flooding your area. Where are you going to pack your things? Where are you going to move your family? What happens to them? Are they going to live in the sky? They can't even cross the local jar because there's no road.
I understand what you're saying. You say you're talking like a Nigerian, displaced Nigerian. Agree, Nigeria. We correct. There's no two ways about that. Now the mistake has been made. The government never made provision when they heard this news that there's going to be flooding. So now this, I think we should be appreciating at least the government.
Don't be surprised that at the end of this thing now, they were going to tell how many billion that have been spent on aviation or the suffering of those who are displaced.
Okay, quick one. If I should ask, what do you think we should do to assuage this flooding challenge in Nigeria? First, to safeguard our farms, our properties, and also the families that are displaced. What is the role of the government? What is the role of the family? The role of people?
We don't know now. We are about to enter food shortage. The oil and farm that have been destroyed. How many hectares of land have been destroyed? We are going to enter into serious food crisis in 2023. It's beyond the electoral campaign they are doing. Our politicians are more concerned about the election. They are not concerned about the food shortage we are going to enter. The federal government has insisted that border remain closed. Now we want to enter into real food crisis in 2023. And government is not talking about anything after that at all. So it's not a matter of whether we are going to assuage. What we should begin to assuage now is that what has happened in Nigerian culture.
Correct.
I don't say that Nigerians are the most special people we can ever deal with. Nigeria is most forgiving people we can ever deal with. Now, what has happened has happened. Now, what's about to happen now, which government is pretending, government from all levels, so from local government, as they are not hearing, is complete food shortage. That means hunger in the land in 2023.
Okay, what you said,
the bag of rice now is 43,000. Look at rice, so
it's correct. There's going to be, as consequences from the flood, there's going to be shortage, food shortage. What do you think the government should do now?
What government should do now?
Yes.
Beautiful. Government should leave politics for now. Government should now drug themselves back and see
politics, they cannot leave politics now. 2023 election.
How they should sit back.
Nigeria is on a timetable, so they cannot leave the election.
Let us the timetable when people are dying. 5,000 people gone. 90,000 people displaced. Hectares of farms destroyed. What they should not come. I've not seen House of Assembly member in any state or even the House of Rep or Senate coming up to propose what you should do to assuage the hunger that's coming in the land. Federal government should begin to look, because I'm going to about having another COVID-19. But this, if about the COVID-19 lockdown, and this one is that we're not going to be locked down, but they're going to be locked down by hunger. So federal government of Nigeria, state government of Nigeria, should begin to look inwards and how to bring food in. On subsidy, if you mean to go into another land or whatever, go and start bringing rice or bringing what, they should go and start bringing it now before people start dying of hunger. On subsidy, we can pack our car, no wahala, but let our children not go hungry. And when the cost of food is affected, the cost of everything skyrockets. Even the woman that has a primary school or nursery school in her kitchen will increase the fee.
So what we're saying, in essence, you know, you talked about you've not seen any House of Rep member or any Senate. This is a platform for you to reach out. I think they will have the opportunity of listening to you. You understand? Listening to you, maybe you might be surprised. You see them presenting it in their various floors. So what you're saying is there should be food subsidized. They should subsidize
protection of food now. That right now, okay. Now this one that we are now.
Okay.
Because the annual rainy season in Nigeria
that's
comes by the month of June. Okay. So for 6 months now, they should now begin to see how to reduce forex for importers to go to whatever I want to go and search for what I'm bringing to bring to Nigeria.
Okay.
And again, remember, the WTO also talk about hunger coming in the land because of war in Ukraine. So now it is the time for us to begin to stock and food now. That's still opportunities. We should go and begin to bring now, begin to stock. So when the hunger begins in December, so that people can be able to buy rice. Rice now is 42,000. So by December, it might reach 100,000. Imagine what you as a president are going to take to your mother in the village.
It's okay. So I think what the government would do, just like you said, you talked about looking at forests, how they can subsidize forests for importation.
Not importation of food. Hold on. When I say food, the basic food a Nigerian person needs is very simple thing. I don't know how we look like looking for trouble. When I say food, they begin to go and import beer. It's not beer, can't drink. The food is rice first. Because rice now, Nigeria consume more rice than anything. Then those who have small yam in their barn or whatever, we can begin to excavate. If not, we go to neighboring Cameroon and begin to bring. We'll talk about other food. What I mean food, edible food, not drinkable food. Because if we say food now, subsidizing food, so people will go and import already made stew into the country. That was not allowed. But when we talk about food, we talk about edible food, food they can cook and eat. And that does not give some countries the impetus to begin to prepare plastic rice for exportation to Nigeria. We won't accept that one.
It's okay. We talked about subsidizing forests for food importation, as in one of the things we need to do, because we're going to face hunger in the land.
In the next 1 month, it will start happening.
Due to flooding. That's okay. I think it's a good one. But after the flood, don't you think they should still look at dredging the River Niger? They should still look at building the Desert Dam? They should look at maybe construction of IDPs? They should look at things, maybe providing things, maybe homes for these displaced persons, so that subsequently we will not face the challenge the way we are fixing it.
I've said it now. What do they need to do? Instead of building what they call housing, 1,000 housing for civil servants, and hike the price to 17 million for a civil servant, I wonder how the civil servants are going to raise 17 million to claim his house. the civil servant leaving there for politicians to go and buy from the back and they begin to rent. They should use that money, build a state-of-the-art IGP, fence it and lock it in case there's emergencies like this, whether by virtue of insecurity, by virtue of natural disaster, such people will move into IGP. And IGP should be every local government. It should not just end in the states. They should just be with a 500 housing units, 200 housing. It should be, and it should be left there for people to a house whenever they have issues. There are people that even have the issue of house burning, their house being raised down. It is a responsibility of the government to see how they can keep them safe in the meantime. But here you are, when somebody's house is burnt, they have no option than to look for a friend or to go back to the village.
It's okay. It's okay. Thank you so much. So everything you've listed out, you talked about the dredging, the need to be done, and also the IDP also.
If it pleases the federal government to dredge,
yes,
well, thank God they are dredging the Niger. And we know dredging the Niger did not stop with the Niger. We want to talk about dredging of the Niger, talk about dredging it from Kebedon to Benue, now talk about dredging to Lokoja, up to where the river ends, up to Katangura and Sokoto, that is Kebbi State by Yawuri. Then you now talk about dredging it up to River Niger. So it's a massive project. But if we have good drainage system, it can help. If we have that dam, as if that dam is generating 300 megawatts of electricity, of course, it's a plus to Nigeria's generation. Assuming that dam is irrigating 150 hectares of land, it's also a plus in terms of food supply. But all these things are not done by government because governments, successive governments, are only interested in sharing oil revenue.
I wouldn't want to go into oil revenue. I wouldn't want to go into the oil.
I want to tell you what they are doing now.
Okay.
They are interviewing me.
It's okay. It's okay. Thank you so much. I think the message has been passed across. The government should try as much as it can to look at all these solutions you gave. But you see, also, you talked about the drainages that were built by P2B, and they are all.
I'm using Anambra as a case study.
The individual also has a role to play. They are the one blocking the drainages, are they not? And those people building houses on such places that are prone to flooding also should.
Who approve it? Is it not the urban planning of the state?
Most of them and don't have approval.
No. My brother, you cannot raise a structure in an urban area without approval of the state urban development. There are the people who approve of it. There are the people who approve of it. You cannot come to an urban area and you don't have waste management system. That is wrong. Effective waste management system. So when you are talking about individual, it's not individual. The role of an individual is to sell his land. Then the other one is for the project to be monitored. My brother, there's no state in Nigeria where we have strict rural urban planning working efficiently and effectively. Give me one. Not even in Lagos or Abuja. Once you buy land, you don't want to be a developer. Go out, just get a small bribe of 5 million naira and you get a project done. They will change it.
It's okay. Esteemed viewers, we've listened to Chidi talk to us today on the flooding and things that we need to do, especially the government, what the government needs to do, the causes of the flood, how it started from the dam, the Lago Dam in Cameroon that was opened, and also how the increase in rainfall across various parts of the country, not just the country, various parts of the world, has led to the increase, the flooding menace that we are facing today. And also, what we need to do, we talked about the drainage system, we talked about dredging, though he's not committed to dredging. He said if the government can do dredging, they should go ahead. If not, they should leave it. Why would do other things? And also, we talked about the need for government to provide adequate IDP camps, so that when such things happen, you can easily relocate people to these places. And also, we talked about some governors, the governor of River State, or the government of River State, providing 1 billion for internally displaced persons in Rivers State, and Bayelsa are following suit, providing about $400 million for these displaced persons. It's a challenge that we are all facing, and I believe definitely the consequences, like you talked about, the food shortage, when it comes, the government will be ready. It's an opportunity for us to be prepared. Definitely, it's going to come, but I believe we're going to be prepared at the end. Mr. Chidi, one final word. Do you have anything to tell us, as in one final word for us?
One final word is, if our leaders are sleeping, they should please think about Nigeria. They should please not think about those who are knocking on their gates to collect 2,000 naira. They should think about how to solve their problem once and for all. Problem of hunger, problem of poverty, problem of Medicare, problem of how to shelter, and so on and so forth. They should think more about that. Not all about, hey, how many people are there? Go and give it to 2,000 naira. The situation in Nigeria have passed and surpassed that stage. We are even in a perennial period where our politicians need to sit and think, and think how best to solve the problem of Nigerians.
Thank you so much. That's intense. We heard what he said. Those of us in government or wherever we find ourselves of different places of responsibility, we should think beyond those people that we give to 2,000, like he said. Your government official, you should look beyond that. Look at how you can better the society. You know, sometimes when I see our governors travel out, you see them in UK, they take train, they go for their various functions. But in Nigeria, it is not like that. You understand? I begin to wonder, don't they see the level of development there? Why don't they bring it here? You understand? But we've listened to what Mr. Chidi said. I believe those of us in position of authority put this to work and see how we can better the lives of Nigerians. Thank you so much. Mr. Chidi, it's lovely having you on set.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much. And to our esteemed viewers, this is Noble TV for you. You're going to like your comment and you share. Thank you so much.